Ra ra a a Roma Roma ma ga ga ooh la la what you about romance.
In other news, America is in day three of a government shutdown. Now, there was a glimmer of hope over the weekend when the Democrats offered to pay for the wall in exchange for DACA support, but the White House ultimately rejected it. Democrats and Republicans are blaming each other. What are we seeing here?
Go ahead. Do you want me to start with this? Okay, sure. So I've been talking about this literally all weekend. Somebody's yelling about something already. I hate the government shutdown too. The first thing I want to say is I think there's a sort of misunderstanding about exactly what's going on. This is about a government spending bill and the DACA attachment. And Democrats want to negotiate on something that has absolutely nothing to do with our spending bill and ultimately has up until I think the March deadline to get done. And I think if you had a problem with the government shutdown in 2013, which I certainly did, you should have a problem with the government shutdown in 2016. But honestly, in 2013, Ted Cruz and John Boehner, rightfully so, got a lot of the blame. And this time, I don't understand why Chuck Schumer isn't getting any blame. And I just want to throw to one clip to show the hypocrisy of both people speaking out of both sides of their mouth.
You know, we could do the same thing on immigration. We believe strongly in immigration reform. We could say we're shutting down the government. We're not going to raise the debt ceiling until you pass immigration reform. It would be governmental chaos.
So governmental chaos if Democrats decide over immigration, which is exactly what they're doing, to shut down the government.
I think it's clear that Schumer learned from the Republicans in 2013 because they tied the spending bill to trying to repeal Obamacare. And I agree with you. It's wrong on both sides. But I will say this. Republicans had 8 years to do something about DACA. The deadline is fast approaching. And the reason the deadline is approaching is because this president yanked it. So he sort of set this whole thing in motion. And in 2013, he tweeted something like Obama is responsible here it is. Why Americans have to worry about a government shutdown is because Obama refuses to pass a budget. Well, now it's Donald J. Trump's
but the
turn.
The question I have right now is, in the negotiations right now, that's not accurate. It's not accurate. The question I have for you specifically, because I know DACA is a big issue for you, Anna, is that Luis Gutierrez yesterday said he would hypothetically agree to building this wall if DACA got passed. Do you think that's a winning idea for Democrats at this point?
Yes, and I think they've already offered it to the White House. I can't understand why the White House is saying no to something that's got over 80% approval. I mean, not even puppies get 80% approval in America today, and DACA does. Look, I'm not only against the government shutdown, I'm against the whole damn government. The reason, it's dysfunction. What we are seeing, what we are witnessing is dysfunction, and the reason that a non-germane, that means something that's got nothing to do with anything, is getting attached to a spending bill is because they can't do their jobs normally. This is what usually happens. They gotta find a vehicle that is a must-pass in order to get anything done.
Well, let's also take a look at the timeline of all of this, because in January 2017, he said, we're gonna take care of those kids. That's Trump. Mm-hmm. September 5th, he officially ends the DACA program. Then in September 13th, Chuck and Nancy, they reach a deal with Trump where Congress would legalize the Dreamers in exchange for border security. December 7th, Democrats agree to a two-week spending measure that doesn't legalize Dreamers, giving lawmakers time to find a compromise. December 20th, 2017, Democrats agree to another stopgap spending measure without DACA. January 9th, 2018, in a televised meeting. Trump says he'd sign a clean DACA bill. January 18, 2018, Senate Democrats refused to vote for a spending bill without a deal for Dreamers. This didn't happen overnight. Yeah. And in part, you know, remember I said a couple of weeks ago that whole thing that was televised was a setup. That's what this has been.
The bill of love,
because, you know, listen, for me, my biggest problem is I get why they're doing it. They're trying their damnedest because we see what DACA's done. We see that it's not gotten rid of the bad hombres. It's getting rid of folks who are sort of willy-nilly. But pissing me off more than anything is neither side is affected by this. See, this government shutdown, they're still getting paid. That pisses me off.
It's a couple of points. I was thinking
talking about a couple of things about this. I don't know all this other part, really. That doesn't interest me that much, the fighting and the back and forth, who gets the blame. But it's interesting, for example, that the military would be not paid during a government shutdown. During Obama's term, the military was paid, just as an FYI fact. Okay. Yes, that's true. Okay, so then Claire McCaskill, who is a Democrat, puts an amendment on the table and says, let's pay the military while this is all going on. And Mitch McConnell takes it off the table. Now, this is supposed to be the party that's always touting, oh, we love the military, and they will try to fool the American people into thinking that they are so in love with the military that they will pay attention to them, and yet they won't give them the money during the shutdown.
I saw that, too, and it really bothered me because, you know, I saw Mitch McConnell shutting down Claire McCaskill. The reason is because it gives him more negotiation, more leverage to negotiate, because it's something that pulls at all our heartstrings.
But then stop saying you care about the military.
You know, to Mitch McConnell, I would say to everybody, because it's going to happen on both sides, do not play with the people that are defending our national security, that are putting their lives at risk to keep the rest of us safe.
Troops weren't able to watch the championship football game yesterday. Do you think that I want that for our people serving in the military? Of course not. But I think there's a cacophony of blame being pointed everywhere. And quite frankly, you are showing your partisanship if you do not place the same amount of blame on President Trump that you did on President Obama and on Speaker Boehner that you did at the time on Chuck Schumer at the same
time. Okay, I have a question for
you. But it is not intellectually honest to sit here and say this is completely Trump's fault. Democrats are playing partisan politics in the exact same way. DACA is a very, very emotional issue. I agree with you, Anna, that this should be an easy layup, quite frankly, on both sides because of how popular it is. But to sit here and say that this government shutdown has anything to do with my or the Republican Party's love for the troops is just intellectually dishonest.
No, we're not saying that. I mean, do you think Mitch McConnell should have allowed that amendment, allowing for pay benefits for the family of the fallen and allowing for pay for the armed forces?
But this is playing party politics.
Exactly.
We have another month to figure out DACA until March. They're attaching it to a spending bill.
Hold on. Now, we're not. Listen, wait. Okay? If we're going to have this conversation, we're going to have it clearly. And there's too much over talk, okay?
Right.
So everybody it's great. All right?
I understand that DACA is a very emotional issue at this point, but most Republicans are on my side on this one, Anna. And I just don't, it's really difficult for me to understand sometimes why you still consider yourself
because
a Republican.
Because I'm a Hispanic immigrant Latina. Because
I was brought to this country.
And it was not my decision to come here. I came here through no decision of my own. I came here through no fault of my own. Had my parents not had visas, had my parents not had the resources to hire lawyers, I would be a Dream Act kid too. That's why this is personal.